Welcome back to Apple a Day. In today's episode, I'm going to demonstrate how you can use AppleMotion to create a Final Cut Pro transition. So I got AppleMotion running right now. I'm going to go under File to New. And in this dialog, I'm going to select Final Cut Transition. You'll see that when the window comes up, you've got two elements in the timeline, Transition A, that's colored green, and Transition B. So Transition A represents the video that's to the left of the transition point in Final Cut Pro, and of course Transition B represents the video to the right. So if we were to save this just as is, it would make a cut transition in Final Cut Pro. To demonstrate that, if I hit the space bar, Transition A is now on screen, and then bam, Transition B, so that's a cut. So what I want to do is do a reveal of Transition B as Transition A goes away. So in order to achieve that, I'm going to take Transition B and I'm going to drag it over and put it right under Transition A, right at the beginning of the timeline. I'm also going to change the duration of this project to 2 seconds. And I can do that by hitting Command J to bring up the project settings. And right here under duration, I'm just going to highlight it all. Type in 2 seconds. So instead of a basic transition, I'm going to do something a little more interesting. I'm going to create a particle generator that's going to start from the center of the screen and sort of expand out, slowly revealing what's underneath Transition A, which of course is Transition B, and that's going to be the transition effect. So the beginning of my timeline, I'm going to add another group, and I'm going to call it Mask. And in Mask, I'm going to add a circle. And I'm going to center that circle by just choosing Reset Parameter. And then I'm going to make that circle a particle emitter. I'm going to set the birth rate really high to 1400. I want to leave the initial number at 0. The life is okay at 5 seconds because this is only going to last 2 seconds. The speed is going to be 600 with a randomness of 240. And the scale I'm going to bump to 140%. I want to randomize the scale so that they're not perfect circles. So I'm going to adjust the X to be 115 and the Y to be 50. And that should give it some randomness. So if I play this back, it has a cloud-like look to it. And you can see it sort of grows from the center of the screen right out to the edges. So now that we've created the mask, we need to add it to Transition A. And in order to do that, we have to right-click on Transition A and select Add Image Mask. And then we're going to select the mask group that we created and drag it on to the mask source for this image mask. We also need to invert this mask, because if we don't do that, it's actually just masking the content of Transition A, where we want it to do the opposite and reveal Transition B underneath it. So I'm going to select Invert Mask. And if I play it back, you can see the red is being revealed below the green. So I think that's great for our first transition. So I'm going to save this by selecting Save under the File menu. And you'll see that the dialog that appears is different than the standard Save dialog. We can name the template, which I'm just going to call My First Transition. And we can also choose the category in which to save this. I'm going to add a new category, and I'm going to call it Apple a Day. Hit Create and hit Publish. And now that it's published, we can go into Final Cut Pro and test it out. So I've already got a Final Cut Pro project ready to go for us to test out our new transition. I'm going to switch over to Final Cut right now. And I've got two clips here with just a cut between them. And let's say we want to use our new transition. So I'm going to go over to the transitions. And there you'll find the category we just created, Apple a Day. So I'm going to click on that. And look at that. There's our first transition saved and ready to go for us to use in Final Cut Pro. So I'm going to select it. And if you scrub over the selection, you can see the animation that we made. So I'm going to click on it and just drag it between these two clips. So if I hit play, you can see our transition. It looks pretty good. Now, of course, you can resize the transition to make it quicker or slower. So if you go really short, like say 9 frames, it's very, very fast. And you can slow it down. I don't think this particular transition works moving that slowly. The default of 1 second seems to be pretty good. And there you go. That's how easy it is to make a Final Cut Pro transition using AppleMotion. I hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. I'm John Martins. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time on Apple a Day.